Start with our next module, that would be the hacking web application. But hacking web application is based on your Buffer cookbook, so we're going to use this book over here to penetrate over here. And we're going to try to use multiple parts. We're going to try the multiple parts over there, and we're going to try how to install Buffer and what are the major applications we need. So this is a proper set of rules that we're going to follow, but you can see there are Buffer like your community edition, your professional version. You can see they are going to set up your labs over here. These are some setting up your labs. You can download the Buffer, and Buffer are divided into three major parts. You can say professional, community, and enterprise. So the community edition will be free to all. You can see this is a free edition. And in Kali Linux, we already have this version. So you can see over here on the tab, this is a Buffer community edition that will be free for us on the Kali pre-build. So you can see you can download the Buffer from here also. Except, so this is a free community edition, and there will be some restrictions also. The restriction which I was talking about, we are not able to use the new project as non-diff. So these are some tags we are not able to use over here. Use the Buffer as a default part. So this is a proper this is a community edition. This is a very old one, 2.1.0.2. You can see over here. So in this scenario, we're going to try to penetrate one by one all the applications over here. And we're going to read about what exactly the Buffer is. This is a community edition, and we have some limited rights. For example, you can see if you need a scanner, so over here you can see scanner is pro version available, go version for making your POCs. See this one also. So I'm going to share with you a new one, and the Buffer professional version is basically $400. It's a $400 for 1 year. And Buffer is based on your professional or community. You can select over here which one which you want to use. And you can see they have given the Buffer are divided into your Windows base, your Jar base, your Java base over here, your other platform like your Linux, your Mac OS. You can see the Windows 32 bits over there. Some default tools that we can use. This is a this one over here is simply setting up your lab. Either you can simply set your own environment with a local machine, or you can try a different time. So it's all about setting up your lab over here for the first chapter, but the main chapter will come from the 12th, second one. So you can see setting up the sitemap, understand the message set editor, repeater, decoder, and tutor. These three tools are the important parts. These three, repeater, decoder, and intruder, and there will be a one called spider also, which comes with sitemap. So, what exactly the Buffer is used for? Buffer is basically used for web application penetration testing part, and over here I already have a Buffer. You can see over here, this is a professional one. In the professional one, you can see this is licensed to Kali, And this is, you can see, we can also select the new project on list. The new project on list over here also, and the open existing project. So for the right time, for right now, we are going to do the temporary project. Use default proxy. So over here, you can see that we can use BuffSuit in a proper way over here. So this is a proper dashboard of a BuffSuit. And whatever the things we're going to perform over here on our browser, it's going to replicate over here. It's going to show all the tab histories. But first thing first, you have to simply use the, you have to set the BuffSuit certificate. So over here, we're going to try to use a proxy server to set up our environment variable. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to try to install the CA certificate, or we can say setting up your proxy server. So in the proxy tab, you can see over here, in the proxy tab, you will see interception tag is basically used to read the packet analyzing part, the packet request. History, it will show all the history tabs over here, which can be used for the further thing. WebSocket is all about history, and the option tag. The option tag will install the two things, the BuffSuit listener. We're going to have to activate the BuffSuit listener for monitoring all the traffic over here. So this book will let us simply setting up the part. So you can see you have to select temporary project, use default project, how it works. You can see over here using either plain jar, or you can see listening with the traffic using BuffSuit, and the BuffSuit will use to simply analyze the traffic over here. Buff is described as an intercepting proxy. Intercepting proxy means we can simply read the analysis of the traffic we generated over here from the client side. This means the buff side between the user and the web browser of the application web server intercept all the traffic following between them. So it's like a monitoring tool. This type of behavior is commonly referred as a proxy service. Pen testers use intercepting proxies to capture the traffic flowing between a web browser, web application, or the purpose of analyzing the manipulation. You can see a tester can pause the HTTP request, thus allowing parameter tampering prior to send the request to the web server. Yeah, we always do a www.google.com request. So whenever you are using the BuffSuit for the first time, remember you have to set the proxy server. It means the proxy listener. So the proxy listener will work on our local host IP address. That would be our 127.0.0.1. This one. Buff proxy uses listener to receive incoming HTTP traffic to your browser. You will need to configure your browser to use this listener as a proxy server. Or you can add some other port number that you want to bind. That by default, the port number is using for the protocol 8080. Or you can specify the host number. 105 is my attacker IP address. By default, sometimes we use the local host 127.0.0.1 port 8080 for making a HTTP connection. But over here, we have HTTPS also. For that case, in the BuffSuit, we have to install a CA certificate. CA certificate for the community edition, it will be valid for 7 days. In professional version, you have to install each and every day a CA certificate when you're using BuffSuit. Each installation of BERP should generate its own CA certificate that proxy listener can use to negotiate TLS connection. See, you can import or export that in certificate for the use of other tools and other installation of BERP. You can see regenerate CA certificate. You can click over here. And the CA certificate will be generated on the IP address HTTP BERP. You can write HTTP BERP. HTTP okay, I guess something went wrong. If this one is not running, you can use the localhost IP address and the port 8080. You can use the 127.0.0.1 on the port 8080 that can be used over here for the further stages. So we can either try other things one by one over here. So all you need to install the CA certificate. See, this will be a CA certificate.dir file. If you open the file, you will see something like port figure CA certificate. And you can see the number of encryption standards they are using. So this CA certificate is basically used for intercepting the HTTPS packet, because we have the other websites also. So this is the CA certificate we're going to install over here in our browser. This will be mediated because all the traffic will be generated over here, because this is a web application part. So for this reason, you can simply go to your preference IT. On the preference tab, you can find for the preference like certificate. You can see certificates over here, view certificate, and the view certificate you will see certificate manager with authorities directory. In authorities directory, you have to install the CA certificate, as you can see your certificate. So we're gonna go to the authorities and we're gonna import the CA certificate that we have downloaded over here. Do you want to trust PortSwagger CA for the purpose to identify website, to identify email users? We're gonna use this one from this two. And okay. So the CA certificate will work as normal, but the major part comes when you have to simply intercept the request. You have to set up the localhost IP address to simply assign or simply monitor the traffic. So this application I will install in my, this IP address I will install, I simply will implement in my browser. So you have to go to the preference directory again. And this time you have to search for the network proxy. See this one, you will see configure proxy access to internet. You will see use proxy system will be a default one, but you have to use the fourth one, which is your manual proxy configuration part. For intercepting the traffic, you have to use the 127.0.0.1 traffic with the port 8080. And you have to set all this proxy server for all protocols. And you will see no proxy for this. But remember one thing, when you are done with the BERP suite, so you have to go back to the network proxy and you have to select again the use system proxy again, because otherwise the network will not work. Remember this one. This is an important point. See this one. It's working fine with the HTTPS certificate. But what happens when I use the, you can see the traffic has been monitored over here. Now I can see that I can monitor all the traffic. That was google.com. See, the 30th request was the google.com. Let's go to the website like YouTube. You can see the YouTube traffic over here. So you guys can see over here that all the traffic has been intercepted with the help of Buffett. And the most important thing, the request and the response. That's the important thing. The request which is created by the client side and the response which is responded by the server side. When we are doing www.google.com, facebook.com, we simply use our client request. For example, you can see I was simply saying if you want to learn web application testing part, I will prefer this book for you guys. The Web Application Hacker Handbook 2. This book is the important part. And this book will let you, the first two, three chapters are important. 1, 2, and 3 to understand the web application, where how the web application works. But over here, we need to understand only the HTTPS request. When we are implementing, when we are simply doing www.google.com, we simply make an HTTPS request. This is a request which is created by the client side. All the HTTP messages, request and response consist of more and more headers. Header means your content body. Mandatory blank line followed by an optional message body. A typical HTTP request. You can see over here, get the data which is transferring for the URL section. Accept, refer, user agent. Accept encoding, host, connection, cookie. These are some HTTP message bodies. And you can see the data which is over here. Get method. What is the get method? The most commonly used method is get, which is data is transferred for the URL section. The request doesn't have any message body. So no further data flows with a blank line of the message header. When we are doing google.com from any of the URL section, we simply get a simple request over here like this one. But the major part is the response code, the status code. What exactly the 100, 200, 300, 400 means? Sometimes you have seen 404, which is page not found, 403, forbidden, 401. The first 100 is basically for informational, which is a client request. The 200 indicates the response code from the server side. The 300 means the client request has been redirected to a different resource. And the 400, the request contains some error. And the 500, the server encountered an error fulfilling the request. See. You will see something like this one also. 100, continue with send. So you will see something like over here, 200 indicates that the request was successful and it has response body content. 201 created and written in response to put request to indicate that the request was successful. 301 permanently moved to redirect the browser permanently. 302 found redirect temporarily to a different resource. 304 not modified. 400 the bad request indicates that a client submitted invalid HTTP request. 401 unauthorized indicates the server requires HTTP authentication. 403 forbidden indicates that there is no one is allowed to access the requested resources. 404 not found indicates that the request resources does not exist. 405 methods are not allowed. 1403 request entity is too large. 404 request URI is too long. 500 internal server error indicates the server encountered an error for three requests. So you have to understand all these types of error over here. And the most important part is your HTTPS. The HTTP protocol used same TCP in the transport mechanism. This is unencrypted and therefore can be disturbed by the attacker who is securely portion by the network. So you can see we know about the HTTP. They don't use any encryption standard. But if you talk about the HTTPS, it's essentially the same application layer protocol as HTTP, but it's tunneled over the secure transport mechanism, secure host socket layer, which is SSL. So in this scenario, we need to understand all the things one by one. Okay, Abhishek sir, can you guys give me 2 minutes?
Sure.
Thank you so much. Hey, I'm back. Sorry. Yeah, so we're gonna try to read this one, and we're gonna try one by one. So the first thing over here on the burp suite is all about intercepting or reading the packet. So for example, you can see there's an interception tab. So as I mentioned, your interception tab is basically to use to simply capture the request parameter value. For example, this was a YouTube channel. So for example, if I want to hold this request, like this google.com, so this is a simple click and respond part. But what happens if I simply intercept this one? So I'm going to intercept this packet, I'm going to intercept the on, so I mean I'm going to read the packet. So when I simply click on this one, the packet has been stopped. You can see the packet has been stopped over here. The packet is totally stopped over here. So what are we going to do? You can go to the burp suite and you can read over here, the packet which is over here. See. So this is a proper request which is intercepted by the client request. You can see this was a normal request parameter, which has a get method. The HTTP version that we are using right now is 1.1. The host tab is basically the website you are going to. So it's www.google.com. The user agent, the mediator, the browser we are using is our user agent Mozilla. And you can see the accepting language we are using is HTML, your HTML text parameter with XML part also. The accepting language is English. The encoding encryption standard is gzip and deflect. And your cookie parameter with your session parameter. And you can see the connection is closed. So you can see the raw size of the packet file. Or you can do parameter, you can go to the parameter and you can see these are the parameter values. These are cookie parameters, you can see. And these are the name of the parameter values. See. These are the parameter values. So the most important part of this request parameter is to understand the client request. What exactly is transforming from the backend side? Transporting. The header parameters, you can see these are the header parameters that we use, and these are the values. And in the backend part, they basically understand the hexadecimal value. With the 0 to 9, 8 to F, 10 to 19, and 1A to 24. It will go like this. These are some offset values. And you can see these are some encrypted data which is transferring. And these are binary code. Either you could forward the packet, either you can drop the packet. If you drop the packet, the packet will be not forward for the next step. For example, you can do the action. What kind of action you want to perform? You want to scan? Do you want to passive scan, active scan? These are the important parts over here. Or you can see open in browser. So if I simply forward the packet, it will be go over there. See this one. Now I can't drop the packet because we already see the data. So the major part that we're going to do over here is to simply understand the traffic analysis part. So the first thing, the interception part is to simply intercept the client request to be for the modification part. So what exactly I'm going to do over here is simply check all the possibilities one by one. For example, let's have a look on that book of the hacking handbook. The first thing which I can see is a spider thing, which is given in the third part, but it should be given in the second part, because spider is the crawling part, and that is your sitemap, target sitemap. Target sitemap is basically, you can say, it's a proper path or the footprint of the website. What are the folders and what are the directories are present over there? For example, you can see setting the target sitemap. This is a normal website they have given. This is a normal website URL they have given, multi-date. But what exactly is the sitemap over here? You will notice there are two subtables available, sitemap and scope. For the initial proxy setup, your browser, burp, and the web server, you need to have the URL, URL folders and files shown in the target and sitemap. How would I know there are some URLs, different URLs, different folders and files are available over there? Because the sitemap contains all the data structure of the website. See this one. This will be look like this over here. And over here, if you see over here on the burp suite, you have to go to the target tab. See. This is a sitemap of the google.com that we already are using right now. How would I know there was an advanced search directory? There's a complete folder. This is the yellow one, is the folder part. There's a search. There's a Gen 4. There's a mail over there. History tab. Sitemap is just like your crawler or your spider, which is basically used to identify the number of directories. But over here, we're going to take a website called testphp.oneweb. So this would be our text, this will be our target website, that would be home of Acunetic Art. For example, many times as a security researcher, we need to find all the bugs of the website, which can be used an automation tool or the manual way. The bugs would either you can use the automation way or the manual way, it's all up to you. See this one. Now I can see the test.php website over here. See. And if I click over here, I can see these are the directories over there, one by one. So the first thing what I'm going to do, if you have a website, you need to crawl the entire website. It means spider. Spidering is another term for mapping out of the crawling of a web application. This mapping exercise is necessary to uncover links, folder, and files. See, how would I know these are the present over there with a target application? In addition of crawling, burpers, spider can also submit forms in automated fashion. Spidering should occur prior to scanning part. Before the scanning part. Why? Because it will identify all the links and folders on the server. And see, since pen tester wish to identify all the possible path and functionality, the paragraph for looking for vulnerabilities, you have, this is the very first stage where you need to simply crawl the directory. See this one. In this specific bug suite, you will have to go to your dashboard. And you will see tasks. And you will see a new scan over here. The new scan over here is means spider, which is your scan type. You can do the scan type like crawl and audit. Crawl and audit, it will be an active scan to identify the vulnerabilities over there. It's gonna identify the files, links, and folders. Plus, it's gonna do an auditing part on the VA, vulnerability assessment. So over here, we are not going to do any active scan. First thing we have to do is to simply enumerate or identify the parameter values one by one over here. So the crawl path, and what I'm going to do over here, we're going to try to copy the URL. and the URL should be pasted over here. testphp.oneweb.com. And okay. The first thing you see, it's gonna identify all the directories and subdirectories on server side. You can see unauthenticated crawl, and it's gonna take some time to crawl the website. And remember one thing, if you're doing an active scan, it will be illegal if you don't have the permission to perform any scanning part, because scanning is illegal over there. All the output of the scan you can see over here on the target part. Let's do one thing over here. I can see there are lots of websites like account.google.com, activitystream, iconservices.com, Webalizer. There are lots of websites one by one. So what I'm going to do over here, we're going to try to simply use a specific one like this one, testphp.bullhub.com. This will be our target, the main part. So what I'm going to do, right click, and you can see add to scope. Add to scope will be simply highlight the specific one only. It means select only the target one. So if I do add to scope, it will ask me, have you added an item to the target scope? Do you want to burp proxy to stop sending out of the scope items? Out of the scope items means it's gonna not identify any of the unspecific thing. It's gonna identify the genuine one. So I will say yes. Login of the out of scope proxy is disabled. You have to re-enable this one. And one thing you can see, filtering. We're gonna use the filter part. If you click over here, you will see something like filter type, filter from request type, filter by meme type, filter by status code or folders. So if you see over here, filter by the request type, you can see show only scope items. If you select this one, you will see only the website that you have selected, testphp.oneweb.com. And you can see this is going to take some time because this scanning depends on the type of the website also. And you will see all the parameter values over here one by one. You will see parameter values are like 200. You will see some parameter value 200, 300, 400. It depends on the specific time. And if you go to the scope tab, you can see the target website you have selected. Or you can add a new URL path also. Issue definition will let you know all the vulnerabilities of OWASP Top 10. These are the vulnerabilities of OWASP Top 10, which you can see the description and the remediation also. Because in the list of the last time, you have to provide the remediation to secure your website. That could be used for the authentication part. Are you guys are able to understand what I'm saying over here?
So, yes. Basically, this is a tool to monitor the traffic for the web application or for the website, and audit or to find the vulnerability in the web application, right?
Mm-hmm. But first thing, this is a buff suit. The most of the pen testers for the web application, they use buff suit for penetrate their screen. You can see the crawling part will be the important part. You can see the number of requests. The number of requests will be simply identify the parameter values. And if you go over here, you can see now it's trying to crawl the website.
So how to penetrate into the web application or into any website? So that part comes in under CES, or that will come in later courses?
That will come in the CES also. And that part will come in your next Saturday.
Okay, next Saturday. Okay.
Yeah. Because it's all about information gathering. In the server side, we use Nmap now. Now, for the web application, we use the crawling part with the help of Verb Suite. And that time, we use the Spider part.
Okay, so like you know, we are finding how many other directories in a website we have.
Exactly. Right? Yes. Yeah. See this one. But the main file is to find the folder and the links. And the most important part is the parameter values. Attackers mostly try to attack on the parameter values and the functionality of the web application. The functionality part is the important thing over here, where you have to understand all the logic, how the web application works. See this one. Spidering will let you crawl the network ID. Spider status provides the ability to turn the spidering functionality on or off. Or you can see it allows us to monitor quoted spidering request along with the bytes transferred. You can use the custom one. Maximum length that you want. Crawling setups. To identify files, and you can see you can use another functionality one by one.
So that this web application vulnerability VAPT part that comes also under OSCP.
Yeah, a little bit of OSCP.
Okay.
OWASP
is, I think, a different course, right?
OWASP is a security standard, security policy of your web application.
Okay.
Because all you can see, these are the parameter values with the help of crawling we need to identify. But sometimes, if you want to find the vulnerabilities over here, we simply use the active scan. You can see active scan part. You can do active scan or you can do passively scan. Passively scan, it will only identify or it will monitor. But in the active scan, it can identify all the loopholes over here. And you can see this vulnerability over here. The company is using a latest version or the paid version of the Verb Suite. This is a temporary crack version. So if you are in the company side, they are going to use a simple paid version. So in this scenario, you can see in active scan, it will do a simple crawling to identify the vulnerabilities on the server side. So if you look over here, you will see in audit part, the red, the critical ones will be on red and one. See. These are the critical vulnerabilities. And if you leave it for a specific period of time, it's going to find all the vulnerabilities one by one. So half of the work is basically done by the Verb Suite. So you can depend on the Verb Suite to simply penetrate all the steps one by one over here. See this one. See, critical vulnerability that comes in high. And what exactly that vulnerability is? Clear submission of password. What is the use of, what is the backend process? What is the URL that you are using? Issue details, the page contains a form of which following the action. Clear text HTTP. Obviously, if you are using an HTTP website, there is no encryption standard you are using over there. They are only using the HTTP clear text password. Or you can see the password field, use path and password. What is the issue on the backend? You can see some application transmit password over encrypted connection, making them vulnerable to interception. Interception is simply intercept the request or readable format. To exploit this vulnerability, an attacker must be subsequently positioned eavesdropping dropping on the victim network. Eavesdropping dropping is just like to simply have a look one by one. So our major project is to simply check all the vulnerabilities, and you can see if you want to read more about this thing, you can see over here. CV Mitra is a website where you can learn about that vulnerability and what exactly that vulnerability is. You can see missing encryption of sensitive exposure. This is your OWASP top 10 vulnerability. If you look for the OWASP top 10 standard, you can see the first one. And these are some security standards. I was talking about the OWASP top 10, and I was talking about this. Where is it? Yes. You can see the standards that we follow over here one by one for the security reason. And there are many further things that we can use over there one by one to penetrate our skills. And most of the web application testing part, we basically follow the OWASP top 10 standard. Top 10 critical vulnerabilities. And that's why you will see missing encryption of sensitive exposure. And you can see that was the parent vulnerability, C type, and this verified. G misconfiguration, data transmission without encryption. And you can read about the relationship and the external declaration. And the form of JavaScript. And you can read about more many things. Password transmit in clear text. See, this is 2002 years and the number of vulnerabilities. If you come over here, you can see they have found SQL injection also. The request and the response, you will see the payload they are using. They are using select statement with the flip function. The major part is to simply understand how the functionality works. So active scan will let you identify the vulnerabilities automatically. And you can see the server tree is high. It's a critical vulnerability over there. See, there are many more vulnerabilities like cross-site scripting, which is your JavaScript vulnerabilities. six total vulnerabilities and the number of requests. See, if there is a no, this much of number of requests, it can overload the server. Too many requests over there. Seven critical vulnerabilities. There are many other things that we can follow. You can see the issue activity over here also. See. As just like a parameter value, spider, there are many other things also that we can use over here to identify the vulnerabilities one by one. For example, if I come to the book, you can see the scanner part is also important that we have already done. Scanner capabilities are only available in the BOSS Professional Edition. BOSS Scanner is a tool that automates the search of weaknesses within the runtime version of an application. Scanner attempt to find security vulnerabilities based on the behavior of the application. And there are two types of scanners. One is your passive scanner and one is your active scanner. Passive scanner analyzes the traffic passing through the proxy listener. This is why it's so important to purely configure your target scope, that you aren't scanning more than is necessary. Or you can use active scanner, send numerous requests that are tweaked from the original form. These requests modify, they are designed to trigger behavior that may indicate the presence of vulnerabilities. See, active scanner is focused on the input-based bug that may be present only in the client and the server side of the application. Spidering, scanners, you can see report issue. Report issue is also important part where we have to simply identify what are the vulnerabilities has been discovered. You can see a scanner discovered vulnerability and if we add it in the list of issues bug on the target tab. You can see there are lots of issue vulnerability that you can find over here. But they are dependent on the servitory level. Servitory level indicates if it is in the high, medium, and low. It is a false positive also. Any finding marked as false positive will not be appeared to on the target report. False positive is a servitory level that must be manually set by pen tester on the issue part. Confidence level, you can see the confidence level available in this includes certain forms and tentative. You can see they have given a proper value there. How to look the parameter value. And you can search the, you can set the servitory value according to your own need. After the spider scanner, we have repeater, decoder, and intruder also. So what is the use of repeater? Let me know you. So repeater in the simple word, repeater is basically used to modify the client request attacker as per the pen tester. You can use that request parameter and you can modify that parameter according to the attack type. So you can see repeater allow for slight changes or tweaks to the request. And is displayed in the left hand window. A go button allows the request to the review shoot and the response to display in the right hand window. See, you will see something like detail parameter like message detail like your raw, param, the header and the header assessment. Let's try this one. So you will see a repeater over here. This is a repeater. you can see the request parameter and the response parameter. The response, these are not parameters, these are HTTP code, status code. 100, 200, see, normal way. Suppose in the crawling part, you find some parameter values like this one. Artist is equal to 1, 2, 3. And you find some comment, the age is equal to 1. Or I can see we found some pic is equal to 7 also, cat is equal to 1. So, and you see a search parameter also, search.php. Search.php, search is the file type, .php is the programming language, question mark with the test is the parameter, and the query is the value. And you can see the status code is 200 and this is the parameter value. And over here, the length of the packet indicates the size of the content. And this is an HTML part. Let's have this one, search parameter. So we, if a pen tester need to modify this request, all he have to do is to simply right click over here on the specific parameter that you want to modify, and you can select the tank to repeater. Tank to repeater will simply, it will send the request parameter to the repeater part, and you can see the request parameter over here. So the most important thing when you are simply modifying the client request, all you need to change the request parameter value. So this is the raw data, but I can see, if I click on the parameter value, I can see there is a URL, body and body, and there are the name are test, search for and go button. So this search parameter is also can be used over there. For example, what I'm going to do, if I simply run the send button, it will execute the request that we created. And you can see 200 requests that the client request has been fulfilled from the server side. This is a response code from the server. And over here, you can see there are some other headers like your server is Ignite server, with the version they are using 1.19. You can see the data, the date, the connection type is your text HTML, and the connection is closed. X powered by will let you about some of the programming language like PHP 5.0.6. They are using Ubuntu server and the length of the content. So if you want to see the response code, or you can click right click, show response in browser. It will give you a URL. To show the response in browser, copy the URL below and paste into your browser. It's configured to use the proxy. Copy this one, paste it over here. You will see the parameter value that we are looking for. Suppose if I change this value to cross, it will search. The search, think about it. The search parameter can only look the data. Show response in browser. URL and you can paste cross. So if I simply insert a Java payload, a simple Java payload, this is a simple Java payload that I'm going to execute. So I'm going to do skip OpenScript and ClojeScript alert function. In alert function, I'm going to write my some of the names like document dot cookie. The document dot cookie will highlight in the backend database cookie parameter. So this is also vulnerable. So I'm just searching for if I can search any cookie parameters on the backend of the database server. Document means domain. So you can see it's executing. Show response in browser. There was no cookie parameter. So if I do, this is a testing website and you can see sign up disabled, please use the username test and password test. Test. So let's try the again. Show response in browser. And now I can see some cookie parameter, which is login test and test. The percentage 2 is basically the space. Or you can say this is a forward slash. So what I'm gonna do over here, I'm gonna copy this one. So the repeater work is basically used to simply modify the client request according to the server. So if what happens if I simply search for the data value, like 17 vulnerabilities has been found. See. Decoder. Decoder are basically used to decode or encode the data to bypass the web application firewall. Web application firewalls are basically used to simply filter out the client request. For example, if you see login.php, login is equal to test dot percentage test. So what exactly this percentage over here? Either you can use a smart decode, or if you know about this ASCII value, you can use decode as your, and you can see that this was a forward slash percentage slash 24 was just a forward slash over here, or you can use a smart decode. There are lots of vulnerability has been discovered. And most of them are cross scripting and some SQL injection. Repeater, decoder, you can see sequencer. Sequencer is also used to simply use the same session token or same session request parameter. So you don't have to go deep over here, but if you want to learn something, this book can help you out.
So, apart from also to clear the basic means, that is a new thing for me actually, and I hope, I believe for us also. Okay, so I never ever heard about this tool and all this improv suit. Okay, so this book would be good, or the earlier one that you shared with us, that improv suit, I believe
that This is the same book which I showed you.
This one, no? This one is good for the to clear the basics first.
Yes.
Okay, the cookbook. Okay.
The purpose of cookbook, because for the web application testing part, you should know the basic concept. And for learning the web application part, you should go through this book.
Okay. So this will come later to clear the basics first. What is that and how it works? The first one is the good one.
Yes, the first one is the for the this one is for only for your bob switch, and this one is basically used for your web application testing part.
Okay.
So when I simply started my career in the cybersecurity, I could just read about this book because this is totally web application.
Mm-hmm.
And this book is based on your website security testing.
Today's session, that is completely new.
This is totally new because I told you, because these are interconnected.
Mm-hmm.
So there should be around 4-hour classes.
Four more classes on it.
Yeah, 4 hours. 4 hours.
4 hours. Okay, 4 hours.
Because now, when we do the next module, that would be totally different. That would be OWASP top 10.
Okay.
SQL injection, process scripting, sensory exposure, what is the use of that one? We're going to try all these things one by one.
Mm-hmm. We can consider that this BrubSuit software as a MSF console like that. Means completely a framework.
Yeah, this is a community. You can say that. You can see this is the Metasploit framework. You can see this BrubSuit burp, start burp. Because in BrubSuit, there are lots of things. There are some additional tools that you can use over here. And if you go to the extender, you will see burp store. There are lots of tools that you can use over here. There are lots of tools.
And now I have to give the time. The earlier topics were, I was aware a little bit, but this one is completely new.
Yes, now you have to give a lot of time in this thing.
Correct.
You have to simply set up the proxy server. You have to simply set up the CA certificate. Now you have to understand the web application behavior.
So how to set up this lab, just we have to install this software and that's it, right?
Yes. You have to install the software. You already have installed the software over here. You can see BrubSuit.
Okay.
But that would be a community edition and this is a professional version.
So you have professional version. It's a crack version, right?
Wait.